Operator overloading allows operators to be redefined and used where one or both of the operands are of a user-defined class. When done correctly, this can simplify the code and make user-defined types as easy to use as the fundamental types. As we can see in this example, we have a class called minum with an integer field called val and a constructor for setting that field. We also have an addition method that adds two minum objects together and returns the result as a new object. If we create two instances of minum, we can add them together using this method. What operator overloading does is allow us to simplify this syntax and thereby provide a more intuitive interface for our class. To convert the add method to an overload for the addition sign, we replace the name of the method with the operator keyword followed by the operator we want to overload. The white space between the keyword and the operator can optionally be left out. Since the class now overloads the addition sign, we can use this operator to perform the needed calculation. Keep in mind that the operator is only an alternative syntax for calling the actual method. Addition is a binary operator, that is, it takes two operands. The first operand is the object from which the method is called, and the second operand is what is passed to the method. When we overload a unary operator, such as the prefix increment, we do not need a method parameter, since these operators only affect the object from which they are called. With the unary operators, we should always return a reference of the same type as the object. This is because when using a unary operator on an object, we expect the result to give us back the same object and not just a copy. On the other hand, when using a binary operator, we expect a copy of the result to be returned, and therefore we return by value. Not all unary operators should return by reference. The two postfix operators, increment and decrement, should instead return by value, because the postfix operations are expected to return the state of the object before the increment or decrement occurs. Note that to distinguish the postfix from the prefix operators, they have an unused integer parameter specified. C++ allows overloading of almost all operators in the language. As we can see in this table, most operators are of the binary type. Only a couple of them are unary, and some special operators cannot be categorized as either one. There are also some operators that can't be overloaded at all.